سديدا أحرف عربي مفيدة بالقرآن سديدا وبها أقرأ قرآني وبها أقرأ قرآني حتى يكتم الإيمان
الله الله
حتى يكتم الإيمان
الله الله حتى يكمل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. In the name of Allah, the Compassionate, the Merciful, all praise is due to Allah. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His Prophet Muhammad, His family, and His followers all until the day of resurrection. I'd like to welcome you to this new episode of the stories from the glorious Quran. And we have today some beautiful stories coming about first the people of the cave. And this is a known story, by the way. Many Muslims do read the Surah of Kahf, the chapter on the cave, during the day of Jumu'ah, because one of the important things that our Prophet, peace be upon him, instructed us to do was to read the first 10 ayahs or the last 10 ayahs or verses from Surah Al-Kahf in order to prevent us from the trial and tribulation of the Dajjal, the false Messiah. Now, obviously, when we talk about this very, very important story, we need to learn something, but it's one of the ways the glorious Quran tells us to be taught things of the past history in order to learn from these incidents did take place in the past, so that we'll have some of the wisdom of what happened to some people in the past. Now, talking about story of the people of the cave, let me read from chapter of the glorious Quran. Now, this is chapter 18, Surah Al-Kahf, starting with verse 9. Now, verse 9 said, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. Now, this is an address to the Prophet, peace be upon him. Did you not think about the people of the cave and the tablet, which was actually kept for their own history? Let me summarize this, because the beautiful verses of the glorious Quran do tell us something very, very nice and eloquent. And the way the story develops, now starting with these righteous people, young people, because in the glorious Quran, in the terminology of the Quran, they were fitya. Fitya is are people who are very young, still full of compassion and love of what they do. And obviously, during a time when there was so much disobedience of Allah and love of Allah on the part of these young people, they actually did not find any way except to escape from this society that was so much corrupt. There was no way that these people could live and coexist with the dominant society in their own time. This in no way would tell us that our own young people could go and escape the society. But at that time, all people, most people that in fact were worshiping idols, and these people, it's just an interesting way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided these few young people to come and to resort to a cave. Now Allah says, إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. They resorted to this cave, which was in the mountain, and this was during the king by the name of Diqyanus in some part of the northern Syria, probably in part of the southern Turkey today. They did not know themselves, by the way. They did not know each other. In fact, everyone was afraid of the other, up to that extent where they were fearful that if they disclosed themselves and they disclosed their iman, they would be having some trouble. So what they did, actually, they were praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, give us from you some mercy and make our matter easy for us. So Allah brought them to this cave. They finally knew each other and what they were about. They were just trying to get away from oppression of the tyrants and those who were worshiping the idols, and they were after the Muslim people at their own time. But Allah created some miracle out of their staying in the cave, because they spent there a number of years. But then Allah resurrected them so that He would, in fact, tell us an important sign about His own ability to bring back to life those who would die. Of course, the normal way for people to die is to die in this life and to wait until the hereafter when they will be resurrected again. But Allah gave us the sign where they were brought back to life here in this part of the life, as we call it, the dunya. Now, Allah is telling the story to Prophet, peace be upon him, in fact, to tell us about, people who disbelieve in the hereafter. And there are many who disbelieve in the hereafter. Now, this came to the whole of the story, or the whole chapter of the cave, came after the people of Quraysh, at the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him, asked him three questions. They said, well, tell us about some earlier young people who resorted to a cave, if you know their story, and also tell us about a man who moved about in the earth, and also tell us about the spirit. All these three questions were given to the Prophet, peace be upon him, as a challenge. And they said, well, if he would tell you the response to these questions, he is indeed a prophet. And Prophet said, I will give you the answer tomorrow. He was hoping that Allah would bring the revelation to him down. He would have the answer. But then the answer did not come in 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, even a week, 2 weeks. After 15 days, the answer came. And in this surah, Allah says, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. Don't say that you will be doing something and unless you say it is by the will of Allah. إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. Say, inshaAllah, because, you know, nothing could be done without Allah's will. And even the Prophet made that mistake. And he even tells us about the Prophet Sulaiman, peace be upon him, who said that I will be going to 100, because he was a man that married many women. And he said, I will go tonight. I'll stop by 99 women, and I will be getting a child from every one of these women so that I can have them as soldiers in the path of Allah. They will be righteous young people. But then look at the end. What happened is only one lady got pregnant out of that incident, and only with a half of a person. There was only half a child, a little young boy, because the Prophet ﷺ said that had he said inshallah, it would have been given to him, but he did not say inshallah. So this is important. This is one way to teach us. What we need to do is to put everything back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, everything is in his own hands, and he has the control over everything. In this case, these are people whom Allah has made their hearts firm in belief. وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِذْ قَامُوا فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَنَّدْعُوَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِلَهًا لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطَ. This is our Lord, is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. We will not call anyone as God, otherwise we would be doing injustice and transgression if we do that. And of course, they said about their own people, هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ آلِهَةً لَوْ لَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. Since they had this belief in the oneness of Allah the Almighty, who is worthy of worship, and no one else. And they said, well, this is our own people. And they said, we will not take any God from him except with strong and evidence, and there is no one who would have transgression other than Allah. Of course, I do have lots of things and I will continue, but we do have a break and we will be back. So please stay tuned.
القرآن سديدا سديدا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We are back, continuing with the story of the people of the cave. One of the very nice and interesting stories that are being told in the glorious Quran so that we can learn from these stories. Now, we earlier talked about these people in their place and their own time, and the king who was tyrant at their own time, who was pursuing and following them. Now they actually stayed away from their own people and they resorted to the cave. And in fact, one of the important signs, although there are many important signs in this story, is that when they resided, when they slept in the cave for 309 years, now Quran tells us even about the lunar calendar and the Gregorian calendar. And in fact, when you say 300 years in the Gregorian calendar, they will be translated into 309 years of the lunar calendar, because in every year there are about 10 or 9 days that are extra or more. So it's a very interesting way of the glorious Quran, how it dealt with these interesting things. Now, when these people were asleep, the door was to the south, and the sun would come and rise from the east and sets in the west, and it would allow some rays of the sun to enter in order to keep them well in terms of their bodies, but their spirits are of course taken because they were in deep sleep and they were not able to move. But subhanallah, by the will of Allah, Allah is turning them on their own sides. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِطٌ ذِرَاعَيْهِ بِالْوَصِيِّ. They were just turned to the right and to the left so that their bodies will not dissolute in the ground. And as one of the strong signs to keep people away from them is that their dog was standing by the door and as source of protection. And indeed, when you think that they are awake because of their health, the way they look, they're just well, very well. They look so healthy and normal, but they are actually in deep sleep. And of course, if you would look at them, you would just run away out of their own respect and awe and shock as you see them with their own, you know, the way they look. Allah just gave them these signs in order to keep them away from people so that they can spend the time that Allah has given them to stay in that. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrected these people afterwards, and He said, وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ لِيَتَسَاءَلُوا بَيْنَهُمْ قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. They just spent 309 years inside the cave, and they, into the morning, they woke up in the evening, even before the sunset, and they thought that, well, someone was saying, well, how many days have we spent? How long did we spend here? And someone said, well, it's probably a day or even part of a day. يَوْمًا أَوْ بَضَ يَوْمٍ. Then they said, some of them said, well, it's up to Allah. We don't know, really, because they didn't have watches at that time or a clock to keep the time. So they knew that it was up to Allah. They were just, this is what a believer would have. And they said, well, you know, we feel hungry. So why don't you send some of your own people to the town so he can bring us some food? But the Quran is telling us something very, very important here. He said, فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَيُّهَا أَزْكَى طَعَامًا. He should look around and find, you know, which type of food that is more pure, halal, permissible. Not any type of food, but a food that is good and alhamdulillah, that is permissible to you. So he will bring you back with some provision that you keep with. It's not really just you want to stuff your belly and your stomach with food and spend lavishly. This is not the point. The point is, you want to have some provision. And of course, this person, وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, he should be very soft and kind, so that this person will not raise any doubt about himself, because of course, people would know, and then they might catch them, and in order not to be known to people, because they were just fleeing from people. وَلَا يُشْعَرَنَّ بِكُمْ أَحَدًا, you know, no one would need to be to know about you, because if people would find you, they would really bring you back to disbelief and the disobedience of Allah. إِنَّهُمْ إِن يَظْهَرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ يَرْجُمُوكُمْ, they might even stone you until death. Yeah, this is what we call al-rajm in Arabic, and or they would bring you back by force into their own religion, and if you do that, you will not be successful. وَلَن تُفْلِحُوا إِذًا أَبَدًا, you will never be successful if you go back to the disbelief or to the religion of rejection of faith and the oneness of Allah. You know, these people were so much still, you know, even after these years, they're still firm in their own belief, and they want to keep on the right path. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has His own way and wisdom and determination. وَكَذَلِكَ أَعْثَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ, well, you know, it was the time that Allah wanted people to know about them and what they were up to. To give their story is an evidence that He was able to keep them alive and to raise them from the dead or the deep sleep that they were in, and they would learn that whatever Allah promises is true. وَكَذَلِكَ أَعْثَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا. Now, how many people do think about the hour and they have some doubt about it? You know, there are many Muslims, by the way, who believe in the hereafter, who believe in the coming of the hour. Yet, when we talk about the real preparation for the hour, they're not really realizing, you know, that the hour is so close and the hour is so horrible, in the sense that this whole life will be brought to destruction and all the dead will be revived and brought back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And people were not really sure what they need to do with them. You know, they even found, the story goes on like this, when they brought their own money, because they had some money from their own time of the king. Now, things did change from that time, and a new king came, and he was a righteous man, and even society became better after 300 years. You know, things did change to the better. And when they went back and they showed them this currency of what they had, they said, well, where did you bring this from? I mean, this is something very old. And they said, well, now we know that this was from the king Diqyanus at that particular time. And they said, well, we have to know where you are. You know, where you're coming from. And they discovered that this person was not alone. This young man was not only by himself, because there was a group of other of his own companions that were just waiting inside the cave, and they came over. They learned about them, and they, subhanAllah. But after some time, when these people knew they were actually so much into learning what they did, they said, well, go and resurrect some wall or close this cave, so they would stay in their own cave where Allah decided that they would sleep. Let this be their own grave. And some others said, well, we can resurrect a masjid or a place of worship around them, so that we can remember these people in order to learn about them. What is important is actually the significance of this whole story. You know, people were arguing, the Jews and the Christians and people of the earlier times, they were saying, well, how many are they? Are they three and their dog is the fourth? Or were they five and their dog was the sixth? Or actually, they were just guessing. And by the way, this companionship of the dog is very, very important, because, well, a dog could be a good and great companion in this case, and it was given this privilege that the dog in fact, was again put to sleep with them and was risen again. Only very few people knew about this. And Ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas, was very famous in learning about the glorious Quran. He said, I am the one of the few who know about them, and we shall not argue about them. And of course, they stayed there this number of years, 309 years. And Allah says, قُلِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا لَبِثُوا لَهُ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَبْصِرْ بِهِ وَأَسْمِعْ مَا لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا يُشْرِكُ فِي حُكْمِهِ أَحَدًا. There is no one like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has the full knowledge of the unseen in the heavens and in the earth. And he's, you know, you should fill your own hearing and seeing with his own knowledge. Glory be to him, because there is no partner with him. There is no one to share with him in his own decision, in his own ruling. That is the point. So this story tells us about the evidence of raising people from the dead, keeping people alive, even when they are the bodies alive and being nourished. Even with these number of years, 300 years is like three centuries, and yet they were, alhamdulillah, you know, so much into life again as an evidence. And we have learned so much, a teaching to our Prophet, peace be upon him, that in fact you should not say anything, you know, that I will do it tomorrow or in the future, except when you say it is going to be done by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the story is not told just only for the telling of a story, but finally, you know, those people who ask the question about these three things, one of them was the story of the people of the cave, where they actually were told this whole story in details. Of course, the Prophet, peace be upon him, was so much happy that this revelation came down, and he was able to tell the people of Quraysh at his own time, yes, indeed, this is in full the story of the people of the cave, with all their own, alhamdulillah, you know, details, so that he was able to tell these people. And of course, the answer came, but they did not believe in that. Not the Jews who were actually telling Quraysh to ask him these questions in order to challenge the Prophet, peace be upon him, nor it was the people of Quraysh, polytheists, who were actually asking the Prophet in order to prove him wrong. But then, yes, there was some delay in order to teach the Prophet, peace be upon him, to say something that is good, but at the same time, he gave them all what they asked for. And this is the way we need to do, is to be up to the challenge. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there for us to support the believers wherever they may be. So that brings us to the end of our story of the people of the cave, as a sign of the ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to raise the dead from their own death and bring them to life in this life. And this is going to be the same thing for all people at the end of time. And until we meet, inshallah, in the next episode about another story from the glorious Quran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بالقرآن سديدا وبها أقرأ قرآني وبها أقرأ قرآني حتى يكتم الإيمان.